Sometimes life is wonderful, and sometimes it's not. Cherish the good, but always be prepared for life's challenges. If your employer doesn't supply health care coverage and you don't qualify for Medicare or Medicaid, you need to give us a call right now. Private health care is private health insurance for ages 65 and under with medical, dental, vision, and even prescription coverage. To get the coverage you need, call the number on the screen now.
Turnpike Sports Book Report.
And the Turnpike Sports Book Report is brought to you by BorgataSports.com. Your favorite casino is now your favorite sports book, available anywhere in New Jersey, BorgataSports.com. Sign up at BorgataSports.com using our promo code PIKE, that's P-I-K-E, and you get a risk-free bet up to $300 and 20 bonus dollars at BorgataCasino.com. Must be 21 years or older and in New Jersey to place a bet. Terms and conditions apply. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
All right, for this week's book report, I actually don't know where to begin. We've got one state's record handle. We've got multiple deals. We've got multiple launches. We've also got other revenue numbers being talked about.
Well, I will give you your choice of where to start. I try not to get involved in the production and the flow and the order of your stories. But I would suggest we start home, start New Jersey, the big national record.
The big historically
big national record. Yes. There you go.
New Jersey has reported a $668 million sports betting handle for August of 2020. Now, not only is that a record for New Jersey, which their previous record was, in terms of handle, was $562.6 million in November of 2009, it's a historically... It's a historic record number. 2019. Sorry about that.
I wish we were betting in 2009.
Yeah, tell me about it. But no, 2019. I'm looking ahead of my notes here. But this is also historic in terms of U.S. sports betting history. Nevada, they topped Nevada's record handle, which was also set back in November of 2019, of $615 million.
Wow.
Now, everyone talked about, even when sports betting was launching in New Jersey and some of these other states, no one would really unseat Nevada in terms of sports betting. And honestly, I think even after this, you're going to see bigger numbers down the road here in terms of Illinois, Colorado, even Pennsylvania to a certain extent.
Sure, sure.
I'm curious to see what happens with Tennessee, too, once they finally get their self going, because they're not tying anything down in terms of launching sports books except for that stupid 10% hold.
Well, look, when you're talking about New Jersey and sports betting, you got to look at the population density. And we are just packed with people in New Jersey. It's the, what was that I heard? New Jersey has more people per square mile than any other state
Yes.
in the country. So, you know, that's going to translate into more bets and more casino visits and more online casino and online poker. So, you know, we just have more people. And Nevada, it's great. Las Vegas is great. But you know what? It doesn't have the population that New Jersey.
No.
And let me tell you something. When New York gets on the ball and starts, like New York City, where there's a huge population
density.
If they
ever allow that.
Yeah, now you're going to see crazy numbers from New York as well.
Watch what happens in Illinois and Michigan.
Oh, no, yeah, Chicago. When they start really going to town, yeah, absolutely.
And then, you know, one state everyone keeps looking at, and I want to see what happens with it soon, is Ohio. Because Ohio's got a huge amount of sports fans. I guarantee you that's going to be one of the bigger markets in sports betting. But, again, Illinois, Colorado, those two, Pennsylvania, you may see them starting to bring up their numbers just like New Jersey is. As long as Nevada still has that in-person registration, that's going to be a little bit of a problem.
And let me bring this up. The record happened in the month of August. I'm very curious to see what September has for New Jersey, because September is the month where NFL starts, you know, and a lot of betting is on the NFL. When you're talking about sports betting, everyone thinks about football first. And, you know, that should be interesting to see those numbers for September.
Well, that's one of the interesting things about these numbers from Jersey. The top sports betting category wasn't football, wasn't baseball,
well,
wasn't
August,
basketball.
Like I said, yeah.
It was the other category.
Okay, the other category?
It's anything that isn't baseball, football, basketball, or parlays. Basically, the NHL playoffs were in there, MMA, all the other, I guess, fringe betting is what you would want to call it, racing, all that. They were the top category in August.
Okay.
So NASCAR falls under the other. A lot of betting, tennis, golf.
Golf, yeah, no, golf has exploded.
Yeah.
I'm very impressed with the numbers coming out from golf.
Golf has exploded both for betting
and fantasy.
Fantasy.
Yeah.
So it's kind of interesting to watch. And also, regards to New Jersey, their revenue numbers were $39.5 million. That equal to a hold margin of 6%, just under 6%. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's important when you look at other states. Like I just mentioned Tennessee. They want a 10% hold. They mandated that.
Mm-hmm.
So this kind of hold percentage is more indicative of what the national hold percentage is going to be. I don't know how Tennessee is going to work with that, but we'll see. And 90% was mobile betting, the handle of that record handle.
Of course, makes sense.
Yep.
Yep.
So congratulations to New Jersey. They have now, they're the king of the hill right now.
Yep.
We'll see what happens in September.
We'll see.
Especially, I think, even down the road, October may be the launch date of that new Circa sportsbook too. So we'll see exactly how that impacts everything too. September, October, November should actually be fun months to watch all these different states as things get starting to get back to normal with especially with the COVID restrictions. West Virginia reported a sports betting handle of 45.9 million, just under 46 million. That's a good increase from the previous month. I think it's somewhere between 20 and 25%, maybe a little bit more than that. Indiana, this is an interesting state. They reported their numbers. Total sports handle for the month of August was $169 million. That's a 138% increase from July.
Wow.
So they're starting to get themselves back together from all the COVID restrictions.
Indiana is going to have some good numbers because in September, because just from that first NFL game with the Indianapolis loss.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I even threw a little money on Indianapolis. So I can imagine living in Indiana and throwing some money on Indianapolis.
Well, it's going to be even more interesting when more and more launch because they still got some more online sports books coming. Mobile handle was $143.9 million. That's an increase of 123% from July's. They were 85% of the total handle. And according to the numbers here, this was the third best month in terms of handle and hold for the state of Indiana. Again, it's just under 6% hold.
Yep.
So the only reason I'm pointing this out is because we're getting closer and closer to Tennessee's launch. So we'll see exactly how that 10% hold
works out.
And
Tennessee only will have mobile, right? They don't even have casinos.
No casinos. Nothing's tied to a casino. It's run by the lottery, and we'll just see exactly what happens here. Iowa, their 18 licensed sports books reported $50 million in handle in August. That's an increase of 120% from July. And $35 million was online handle, and 15.3 was retail.
Okay.
So we're seeing the breakdown more and more mobile, you know. So states with that in-person registration might want to keep an eye on this stuff too, because that the New Jersey model is the way to go.
Is that what they're calling it, the New Jersey model?
I think so. Yeah, that's
the
only
New Jersey
thing that makes
model.
Sense.
Yeah, that's the model for the national New Jersey. That's when you know you're in trouble when you're following New Jersey's lead on anything,
yeah.
Huh?
Well, let's talk about some of the deals now. Those were the revenue numbers that came out for the month of August. Pennsylvania will be releasing theirs probably in the next couple of days. We're taping this probably after we get done taping this.
Yeah, probably.
We're going to see them release it.
Probably after the mics go silent, when Pennsylvania releases.
As soon as we click off on these microphones here. But let's see. ESPN announced.
That's the big one.
One of the big ones.
But that
this is
the
big one that's taken the besides launching the new show that we talked about in the rundown, the Bet Flash this week. That was called Bet. It was a digital show.
Yeah, for people who didn't hear that, ESPN's launching another sports betting show called Bet
to go along with
Better
Days.
And I guess that's on their digital platforms.
Yes. Yeah. So Caesars and DraftKings are now, and I hate the way this is phrased, but I guess there's no other way to phrase this. They are Caesars and DraftKings with are co-exclusive partners for gambling linkouts with ESPN. I guess there's no other way to phrase that.
Yeah, I guess what they're saying, and let me know if I'm wrong about this. Caesars, ESPN will be using Caesars odds.
Well, they've been using Caesars.
Okay.
Odds.
Well, I guess they made it official then. I don't know.
And no. What this is, this addition to this deal was, anytime you see a sports betting like odds link or prop link, it'll go to Caesars Sportsbooks.
Yeah.
And that's what this means.
And the same thing with DraftKings, except that's for daily fantasy sports.
DraftKings will be what ESPN is, what Caesars is doing with ESPN in terms of providing
them. Not Caesars,
them,
ESPN.
What Caesars is giving ESPN on on the sports betting odds, as well as some of the other sports betting data, DraftKings will be doing the same thing on the fantasy side for ESPN.
Yep.
Both of them get the link outs, though, for the sports betting applications.
Okay.
So basically, whenever you see something going for sports betting, a link to something else, the only two you're going to see right now, I guarantee you there's going to be another co-exclusive deal coming after this.
Sure.
You're going to see it either going to Caesars Sportsbooks or the DraftKings Sportsbook. So it'll be fun to watch this. I always thought they had a deal with DraftKings anyway, but thinking back on it, their fantasy sports side of ESPN stuff was always their own.
Yeah.
And now they basically, I guess, outsourced the betting data that they're working with here. Illinois had PointsBet launch online over the weekend.
Okay.
Don't mean to switch gears here, but I did that kind of rough there. But again, PointsBet launched online only in Illinois over the weekend here.
Sure.
They're partnered with Hawthorne Racecourse. They are partnered with that. They launched online. They plan to do retail books coming soon at the Hawthorne. That's their flagship retail location. They're going to have three OTBs at some of the satellite locations. And they did deal with Devin Hester for marketing.
Well, I remember when PointsBet first launched in New Jersey, they did a deal with Darrell Revis, because I did an interview with Darrell Revis. So, I think having an athlete like that represent you is always a great idea in a marketplace.
Yep. Marketing idea there is great.
Yep.
Let's see. Over in Colorado, we had William Hill launch their sports betting app last week. Let's see. I'm going through my notes here. Barstool Sportsbook is launching this week. As a matter of fact, it should be launching soft launch on the 15th.
When
today.
You say launch, what do you mean?
The Sportsbook app.
Oh, okay, launched. The app online. Okay.
Yes. They launched today for a soft launch. And a couple other deals I wanted to go through here. And again, whatever we don't cover in this segment is going to be on the Turnpike Sports blog in the book report posting. That's going to be posted after this show is published. The NBC, I thought this kind of deserved a little bit more notice here. NBC hired Warren Sharp to provide commentary across their platforms.
Great.
For football.
He's really good. He's really good.
He's going to be appearing across their national and regional linear shows. He's going to do written content, and also do video content for NBC Sports and RotoWorks, RotoWorld. And also The Ringer brought on Sharp.
Great.
Be doing their weekly podcast programs. He's going to be doing betting analysis on Wendy's and Fridays on the Ringer NFL show. And every time he's on, he's one of those guys you always have to listen to.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, especially we do picks on this show. I mean, we try and gather information from all around, and he's one of the guys you certainly have to listen to if you're serious about betting or seriously trying to get some money out of a parlay or an over-under or a prop bet. I mean, he's one of those guys you kind of have to listen to.
Speaking of some of these deals here, Sport Radar had another deal done.
Sport Radar is everywhere. I was watching that betting show on ESPN. What is it called?
Daily Wager?
No. It was on Fox.
Oh, that's you said ESPN.
Oh, so, did I say ESPN? Yeah. I meant Fox.
Bet Live.
It's called Fox Bet Live, but it used to be called Lock It In. They used to be called Lock It In. Now it's called Fox Bet Live. And at the very at the end of the show, you know, it's all the information provided by Sport Radar. So, yeah, no, they're everywhere.
Well, this deal actually shows the kind of dominance Sport Radar has in the data market. Mm-hmm. They did a deal with Tipico, which is a German bookmaker.
Okay.
They're going to be entering the New Jersey market soon. So the deal with Sport Radar, they were going to supply betting data from all major U.S. leagues, NFL, Major League Baseball, National Basketball Association, hockey, NHL. So it kind of shows you when you do a deal with Sport Radar for the Major League sports betting data, you're getting all four leagues.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, they Sport Radar does a great job in that.
And I'm curious to see how Tipico does when they do launch in New Jersey. I mean, it's already got gobs of online sports books. So then they're going to be launching soon. They're also going to be doing a casino, too.
All right.
Tipico.
Boy, New Jersey, I'm wondering if we're getting a little too crowded here. You know, a couple years ago, we had to close down some casinos in Atlantic City to kind of get the marketplace in order. I'm wondering if something like that's going to happen online. You know, one of these online things are going to have to drop away to just to, you know, the law of diminishing returns, too much of a good thing, probably is going to affect the market in an interesting way.
Well, you got to look at every sports betting license.
Yeah.
Gets the ability to do, I think, three skins in New Jersey.
Yep. Yep.
And again, there are lots of different places that are getting licenses. I know Freehold is going to even be launching.
Yeah, no, there's
at
going,
some point.
There's going to be a new retail sports book in New Jersey, and I guess they have some online skins that they can use. I guess they have three online skins.
Yep.
So not only is there going to be a new retail sports book in New Jersey, but I'm sure they're going to have about three skins online.
I'm actually curious to see what happens with Freehold, because that's co-owned between Parks and Penn National. And you got Parks doing the retail,
sure,
possibly, because that's what the delay is right now. Yeah. I don't know what the branding is going to be yet on this retail sportsbook yet.
I'm curious to see how that all gets worked out. I read an article that, you know, because Penn National is some way involved, maybe Barstool would be involved as well. So we're going to have to see how Freehold shakes out.
And you got Portnoy announcing he moved from Boston to Philly. So,
well, he was in New York.
I thought he was in Boston.
He's from Boston. He lived in New York, and I guess he's moving down to Philadelphia. Well, that's what, you know, the Twitter and the news reports are. So, you know, we'll see.
Yep. And one last little note for this week's edition of the Book Report. New Hampshire. Speaking of getting crowded really quick, too, I think.
Yeah, well.
They have launched their second DraftKings retail sports book in the last 2 weeks.
Okay. And where is this at?
This is New Hampshire. It's
Hampshire.
In Manchester.
Okay. All right.
It's going to be the Philotimo Casino and Restaurant in Manchester. It's a Greek restaurant. It's in a little complex kind of thing.
That sounds interesting. Casino and Restaurant. That's the actual name of it?
Well, we had talked about this earlier on in another book report where they were going to be going with Southside Tavern, which is all part of this complex. So it's going to be inside the restaurant.
Okay. All right.
So, you know what? It makes sense because you're going to want to have a full menu complementing everything.
It'd be very interesting to see and how that's laid out. And I'm very curious to maybe drive up to New Hampshire and check it out.
Well, like I said, this is the second DraftKings retail book in New Hampshire. The first one was in Seabrook.
Okay.
Which was the old racetrack, the Seabrook racetrack. There's a casino in that region area.
Okay.
The Brook Casino. Which has the first DraftKings. I actually am curious to see this one, too, because it's supposed to have stadium seating. It's a good-sized book. And this one is going to have the ability to have about 100 people in it, too, this new one.
Oh, see, you know, when you said, you know, sports book and restaurant, if that's in the title, I was thinking something like Borgata, because Borgata's sports book is actually more like a sports bar.
That's,
you know,
what it's going to be.
It's not stadium
like
seating. For Borgata.
The one in Manchester is going to look like that, probably.
Okay.
The one in the Brook Casino is going to look more like
you.
The Parks one. Where it's like stadium seating
or
movie theater seating. I just hope they have better chairs because I'm not a fan of the Parks chairs.
Okay, really? Okay.
Yeah, they're just not that comfortable. I mean, I love the ones in down Atlantic City over in what used to be the Book.
Oh, in Bally's, yeah.
Which is now William Hill. So there's no longer the Book at Bally's AC. It's William Hill at Bally's,
okay,
which is going to change anyway again because you got Twin River coming in at some point purchasing Bally's, and they're going to bring their own sports book in. So I don't know if they're going to change anything when that happens. But again, when I go to the sports books, I actually like when the chairs are really comfortable, and I just don't find the Parks chairs as comfortable as the Atlantic City ones.
Interesting. Okay. Someone should do a study on that. Who has the most comfortable chairs?
An ergonomic study?
Yeah.
So that's it for this week's episode of the Book Report.
And that'll do it for us. Hey, if you're going out to one of the newly reopened casinos and sportsbooks, please be safe and wear a mask. And we'll see you next time on the Turnpike.